Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Image Editor control. The Image Editor is a versatile tool for editing images by adding annotations with text and built-in shapes. You can also crop and flip images. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add Syncfusion's .NET MAUI Image Editor control to a .NET MAUI project. Additionally, I will show you how to perform the rotating, flipping, and cropping editing operations. And you will see how to apply filters, add annotations, and zoom in on images. Before we begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022. And click Create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I select the .NET MAUI application. Then, I provide the project name and location. I create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before I move forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the environment for running the application. Here, I select the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. With the emulator selected, I will run the application. The application compiles a default code, so wait for a few seconds. And now, the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I'll show you how to incorporate the Image Editor control into this application. First, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Image Editor NuGet package. So, I open the NuGet Package Manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the package Syncfusion MAUI Image Editor and select it to install it in my project. I click OK to continue the installation. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI Core hosting namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion Core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it is necessary to register a trial license key. So, I open the app XAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate a trial license key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML file to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI Image Editor namespace. Then, I initialize the control inside a grid panel with the name and load the image into the source property for editing. The image is already added in the image folder in the resources. You can also load an image from a local file, URL, or stream. As you can see that the image editor displays the image and the toolbar is enabled with image editing options. You can zoom in and out of the image by double tapping and using hand interaction gestures. This allows you to adjust the zoomed region both horizontally and vertically. Moving on, if you intend to crop the image, you can choose the crop option from the toolbar. This provides several cropping options, including custom, circular, square, and various aspect ratios. After selecting a desired option, you can define the region to be cropped, and the editor performs the cropping accordingly. In the upcoming steps, I will demonstrate how to apply transformations to an image. For instance, you can rotate an image to the left using the corresponding options. Each rotation will rotate the image 90 degrees clockwise. Additionally, you have the option to flip the image both horizontally and vertically. Moreover, the reset option allows you to undo any changes you've made in the editor. Now, let's proceed to further image editing. If you click the Shape Annotation option, you can add annotations to the image using supported shapes. Similarly, clicking the text annotation option allows you to add text to the image. For more detailed information about these annotation features, you can refer to the documentation link provided in the description. Next, I will demonstrate how to apply image effects. The Image Editor provides a wide range of image effects that can be applied to your images: brightness, contrast, hue, saturation, exposure, and opacity. After selecting a desired option, you can change the image effect values and the editor applied accordingly. Also, use the Save option to save the image. To hide the toolbar, I set the Show Toolbar property to false. Notice here, the toolbar is not visible in the image editor. Now, I will demonstrate how to rotate and flip image programmatically. First, I add two rows inside the grid, and a new button with its text, and the corresponding clicked event. Also customize the button appearance by setting the width, height, and margin to the button. Next, I navigate to the event handler method. To rotate the image, I use the rotate method of the image editor. Each rotation will rotate the image 90 degrees clockwise. You can see that the image rotates 90 degrees clockwise. To display the mirror image, we use the flip method along with the image flip direction, and choose horizontal or vertical. Looking here, I tap on the button. You can see that the image is flipped horizontally. If you want to crop the image without using the toolbar options, use the crop method with the desired image crop type, such as free. To save or cancel the cropped image, navigate to the main page XAML file and add buttons for these actions. First, I place the existing edit button within a horizontal stack layout. I add two new buttons for saving and canceling the selected image region. To save the selected image region, I go to the clicked event of the Save button and call the Save Edits method of the image editor. Similarly, in the clicked event of the Cancel button, I call the Cancel Edits method to discard the editing changes. Looking here, clicking on the Edit button will display a freehand selection region on the image. You can resize or drag the selection region to choose the desired area. Then, tap on the Save button to save the edits. If you wish to cancel the editing process, simply tap on the Cancel button. To apply image effects without using the toolbar options, I use the image effect method by specifying the desired image effect, such as brightness, along with the effect value arguments. The brightness effect values range from -1 to 1, with the default value set to 0. Note that the ranges for the effect value may vary for different image effects. You will see that the image effect is applied to the image. Next, I will demonstrate how to add text and shape annotations to images. First, I am going to add text annotation to the image. So, use the Add Text method of the image editor. Simply set the desired text to display on the image. To customize the appearance of the text, use the Image Editor Text Setting property and adjust it accordingly. Once the application is loaded, tap on the Edit button. You can see that the text annotation is displayed on the image. To add shape annotations without using the toolbar, use the Add Shape method with Annotation Shape. To customize the appearance of the shape, use the Image Editor Shape Setting property and adjust it accordingly. Once the application is loaded, tap on the Edit button. You can see that the given shape is displayed on the image. Next, I will show you how to enable zooming and panning actions. To enable or disable the zooming functionality, we set the value of the AllowZoom property to true or false. By default, the AllowZoom property is set to true, enabling zooming on the image. If you wish to disable zooming, simply set the allow zoom property to false. You can see that zooming is disabled on the image. In this video, I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add the Syncfusion image editor control to it. You saw how to perform various image editing operations and apply filters, add annotations, and zoom in on images. To learn more about the image editor's features, you can check out the documentation link provided in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can see if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.